like it. Mind show, stage door, and the Caucasian chop sir. You can tell you spent a lot of time at this school.
A total of 43,026 hours.
I slept at the call board. We've all been there.
Despite the exhaustion we've all faced, we've learned how to take a play, published or student written, from the page to the stage.
And working together through our failures and successes, we were taught how to step outside of our comfort zone.
The risks we took weren't always easy, but taking them helped us grow as collaborative artists.
Has been, even at times, inadvertently crafted by someone else, some other performer,
some artist who has maybe made me laugh in class with poorly rendered prom comedy, some musician who has turned around in his seat to talk to me, some thespian who I watched painstakingly sew up someone's pants, or some dancer that has proven I could find unlikely friends in even more unlikely places. So everyone is behind this podium together, not because I represent everyone, but because like everyone else in our senior class, I'm just one of the many compositions of what every student in this school has worked so hard to do over the years. We're craftsmen who make art and make people. I've lived with youth at the most vulnerable period in my life, and I wouldn't want it any other way. You all have given me a reason to wake up and come to school in the morning 5 days a week for 36 weeks a year for 4 years. And some of you will never see again. But it'll always be like distant family, like that aunt you only ever see at Christmas about love, and that visceral connection that endears you to her is the only thing you have to think about when you miss her, because you know she's out there somewhere. That's what you all are like to me. Wayward, absentee aunts. That's not a very good example. That's not very sentimental. But you should know that any semblance of you all I will carry for the rest of my life. My thoughts will always be of you and with you, even if they have to push past a crowd of screaming fans or wait for hours at a ticket booth, because family is always there. I'm not going to say that high school makes up the best years of your life, because I feel really bad for people who believe that. We have so much more to look forward to, and we deserve every good thing that presents itself to us because we've worked so hard for it. We're a creative species, yet Booker T breeds an entirely different species. And by nature, we are curious. So I'd like to thank our teachers, our administration, the senior class of 2013, my parents and our parents for never sparing an expense and fostering that enduring curiosity that keeps artists at their easels until 3 in the morning, or 5 in the morning, or 6:30 in the morning, but you know you have to cut it off at 7, so you just throw some watercolor in the blank spaces, and it's abstract. We're okay, guys. It'll be okay. The same curiosity that claims dancers in the studios for the night, the same curiosity that makes lighting crews sort of uneasy nights, and gives musicians the courage to compose. So I hope in college, when maybe you're spending that first night away from home, you don't lose the courage to turn to your roommate and ask, what did you learn today? Because it's written in the novel Diary by Chuck Palahniuk, all the effort in the world won't matter if you're not inspired. Thank you.
take the tassel that should be on your right side. Take that in your hand, in your right hand preferably. Yes? And on the count of three, we're going to change to the left side. You guys want to count with me? One, two, three.